As a physician who has treated hundreds of Chiari patients, this is one of the biggest game-changing papers on Chiari I have seen in years. It was just published in the prestigious medical journal Nature. While it's technical, here are the key points. It's been a mystery for many years why some Chiari 0 and Chiari 1 patients are symptomatic and others are asymptomatic. This paper investigated why that happens by hypothesizing that Chiari may have another key undiscovered variable caused by rectus capitis posterior minor muscle atrophy and denervation. They picked this critical suboccipital muscle because it's a known stabilizer of C0 to C1, and it jacks into the dura, the covering of the brain and spinal cord, through the myodural bridge. As a result, it's a key player in headaches that originate from the neck. They discovered, using a highly sophisticated, randomized, blinded study, that the degree of denervation, lost nerve supply, of the rectus capitis posterior minor muscle directly correlated with Chiari and headaches. This denervation causes the muscle to atrophy, wither away. They hypothesized that once this movement control is lost due to the withered muscle, the ability to stabilize the C0-C1 neck facet joint goes south, and the ability of the rectus capitis posterior minor muscle to control dural infolding, which happens when you look up, goes away, causing more disturbance in CSF flow. Pulling the dura out of the way with specific movements is a key rectus capitis posterior minor muscle function that helps to control CSF flow. That would be doubly important if the flow is already reduced by low-hanging cerebellar tonsils. This would explain why some Chiari patients have no symptoms, their rectus capitis posterior minor muscle works fine, and others do have symptoms, their rectus capitis posterior minor muscle is denervated and atrophied. So how can this new discovery possibly change Chiari treatment? The authors point to the nerve that innervates the rectus capitis posterior minor muscle, the suboccipital nerve supplied by C1, as the cause. To understand how this works, the motor nerves, like suboccipital, tell the muscles what to do. When they are injured or compressed, the nerve supply to the muscle gets cut off and the muscle withers away, something we in medicine call muscle atrophy. If a nerve is just weak, you can strengthen it. However, if the nerve supplying the muscle is damaged, the muscle generally can't strengthen with exercise. This could explain why Chiari patients are often resistant to physical therapy. Our clinic has seen promising results in Chiari patients with craniocervical instability by using ultra-precise ultrasound-guided injections to break up the scar tissue around the suboccipital nerve and inject platelet growth factors to help the nerve. These preps contain nerve growth factor VEGF and BDNF, which we know, based on both lab studies and clinical data and other applications, can improve nerve health. The goal of this new treatment is to get the nerve working again so the muscle can begin to fire and the patient can start to strengthen that muscle in PT. Hopefully this information helps you on your healing journey. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day. You know what to do. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.